Hi, I'm here to give you tips on how not to accidentally kill yourself. Today we're going to talk about fire safety, chemical safety, electrical safety, and back safety. We'll start with fire safety. Now, fire is very dangerous and very hot. To avoid a heated experience, we're going to have to give you some tips. First, don't misuse electrical equipment. Watch as our worker demonstrates how not to plug in a cord. Oh no! Our worker has left the cord halfway out. He could start a fire. But now watch as our other worker is more careful and makes sure that the prongs are all the way in the wall. Great job, worker!
Mister, that's real nifty and all, but I really wanted to know what else could cause such a disaster.
Well, little Billy, that's a great question, and I'll answer it. There are three things that can start a fire. One being heat, the second being fuel, and the third being oxygen.
Pictures copy-pasted from Google.
Wow-wee, that's keen! But mister, what if a fire does happen? I mean, what would I do?
Well, little Billy, if it's too big to handle, remember, RACE. It tells you how to evacuate a fire. R stands for rescue, A stands for alarm, C stands for contain, and E stands for evacuate. But if you can handle it, you use a fire extinguisher.
Jeepers creepers, how in the world will I use that?
Well, all you have to do is remember, pass. P is for pull the pin. A is for aim at the base of the fire. S is for squeeze the handle. And S is for sweep the side to side until the fire is put out. Oh no! A fire has broken out! How will our worker react? Yes, good job, worker, getting a fire extinguisher. But he doesn't know what he's doing, and he gets caught on fire. Our more careful worker knows how to use pass. He pulls, aims, squeezes, and sweeps. Way to go, worker. Now let's talk about chemical safety.
Chemical safety?
Yes, chemical safety. There are some chemicals you should be aware of, even some around the house. You should always have a material safety data sheet ready, or an MSDS, so that you know what to do when a dangerous chemical spills anywhere on your body. Never mix bleach and ammonia. The toxic fumes are lethal. Make sure to never use unlabeled containers, and to always wash your hands.
Wow, that sure sounds dangerous.
It is. And to protect yourself from dangerous chemicals, you can wear personal protective equipment, otherwise known as PPE, as shown here. And there are some things you cannot simply throw away. Oh no! Our worker is throwing away a paint can without doing anything to suppress the paint fumes. Poor worker, his brain cells are being destroyed one by one.
Gee whiz, mister. You seem to know a whole lot about this kind of stuff.
Yes, I do, but I know even more. Next, let's go on to electrical safety. Now, electricity is very dangerous. To avoid a shocking experience, you're going to have to make sure that you use electrical appliances that are not broken in any way. You see this? This is a grounded plug. Electricity naturally tries to find a way to the ground, and this bottom rung does just that for excess electricity. If the bottom rung wasn't there, you'd have a greater chance of electrocution. So please don't try and rip it off to make it go into a two-prong slot.
Gee, mister, what's that cool, refreshing picture of water doing there?
Well, do you think it looks dangerous, little Billy?
Gee, golly whiz, I wouldn't think so!
Well, you're wrong, little Billy. Electricity and water never mix. Shown here is an example of an exposed wire, which you should never plug in. You may get lucky like the person who plugged this one in, but most of the time, you won't. Oh no! Our worker has failed to notice the exposed wires on the cord! Enter our more careful worker. Look, he's just noticed the exposed wires. He's just saved his own life.
Good golly, that's interesting.
Yes, it is interesting. Now let's talk about back safety. If you don't want to break your back or cause severe pains to your entire body, you gotta know how to work your body so that you can keep healthy. Remember to always keep your back straight and look straight ahead. If you keep your feet shoulder width apart, you'll be able to provide a better base. Don't twist your back when you can twist your entire body. Remember, you're lifting a box, not doing yoga. Behold, a box, man's worst enemy. Can our worker conquer this fiend? Uh-oh, it looks like he's using his back to take in all the weight. He should also remember to keep the object close to his body. Watch what happens. But now our more careful worker shows us how to crouch down and let the legs do the lifting. So, little Billy, have you learned how to work safely and keep away from dangerous items?
Boy, I'll say!
Thank you for watching this, and I hope that you will be like little Billy over here. Hey, come on, guys. Stop applauding. Credits have to go. Gosh. Oh,